What's your name?
My name's Edward Aponte. I'm a Lieutenant JG in the U.S. Coast Guard.
All right, so could you tell us about this aircraft that's behind us?
Sure, it's a HH-65 Dolphin manufactured by Eurocopter. It's a short-range search and rescue helicopter. We prosecute search and rescue cases, law enforcement missions, fisheries missions. We do drug busts on them frequently. I'm trying to think of some of the other missions. There's a multitude. We do vertical insertion on cargo ships before they come into port. We'll actually lower a boarding team down to the boat, to the cargo ship, so they can be inspected before they come into the Golden Gate. We fly all the way from north of Point Arena, which is close to the California-Oregon border, down towards Morro Bay. It's the entire search area we cover. It's about 300 miles of rugged coastline that we patrol every day.
Sounds like a fun job. How do you get started?
Basically, you sign up for the Coast Guard. You have to be an officer in order to be a pilot, or you can be enlisted to be a flight mechanic or a rescue swimmer. In order to be a pilot, it's good to have your college degree, so school's obviously really important. You go to OCS, it's Officer Candidate School, that's for 8 weeks, and then from there you can go straight to flight school, which normally lasts about 2 years, and then you go off to your first unit after that.
Now, we'll stay away from that area because it says, danger, stay away, right?
No, that's actually just when it's on. That's the, if you notice, the tail's a little different because it blows the air that way towards you if you're on that side. So, and it's a pretty strong blast, so that's why the danger sign's there.
All right, so let's go walk around here. So, what requirements did you have to know to become a U.S. Coast Guard member?
Well, you have to fall in with all the requirements as if you join any other branch. There's certain requirements depending on what job you want to go into when you take the ASVAB exam. And normally you take the ASVAB exam, everybody takes it pretty much out of high school. And you have to score certain scores in each category for the job you want to go into. I don't have those memorized. The recruiter could tell you each category and what type of score you want for that.
So what inspired you to do this?
I've always wanted to fly my entire life. I'm an Army brat, and I grew up on Army bases around helicopters all the time. So as soon as I got out of college, I knew I wanted to fly helicopters. So I shot for it, and I got it.
So what kind of objects do you keep in here in the helicopter?
We have a basket, which you saw out there. There's a rescue strop and a rescue sling, which we can use to actually wrap around people and hoist them up. There's also an EMT kit, which we don't have on board right now because our rescue swimmer's not with us. In the EMT kit, there's an automatic external defibrillator, oxygen tanks, anything a basic EMT would need to work on a patient or a victim. And we also keep a video camera for law enforcement missions, and we have our encrypted equipment in there as well.
All right, it was nice meeting you.
Thanks.
So you're looking forward to the Thunderbirds coming out?
Actually I am. It's going to be a great time, great show. We're looking forward to it.
All right. So you're the assistant manager of what? The flight training?
I'm more the safety officer, and I kind of fill in for a lot of additional duties out there at the Aero Club here on base. So that's pretty much all I do.
What's your name?
My name's John Cooper.
John Cooper?
Yes, sir.
All right. So how do you get started in flying a plane? You don't want to start off flying a 747, do you?
Well, sorry about that.
So, John, you don't want to start off flying a plane like that, your first time, do you?
Well, no, you don't. You want to start out with something that's real simple, real simple, easy to fly, flies kind of slow, because you get pretty task saturated right at the beginning. So you want to start off real easy, real basic.
So is this like the perfect size plane? Not too small?
Well, I mean, this is perfect size for someone who's been flying for maybe a year or so and has their license, wants to go long distances, and wants to go there fast.
So what type of plane is this?
This here is a TB-20 Trinidad built by Cicada, and cruises about 155 knots true airspeed.
Wow. So is this located here at Travis Air Force Base?
That's correct. It's located here at Travis. It's located at the Aero Club just behind the hospital.
All right. Well, it was nice meeting you.
Okay. Well, thanks for your time.
All right. We'll see you later.
Take care.
How's it going?
Good. How are you today?
Good. What's your name?
I'm Deputy Brian DeMunich.
Nice to meet you. I'm Vinnie Langdon, and you're on the Vinnie Langdon Show.
All right. Good. Sounds like fun.
Yep. Now, Vacaville, they have, you know, police cars that look like actual police cars. Now, this is Contra Costa County, and this doesn't look like a regular police car.
Right. Contra Costa County, we do things a little different. No, actually, this is one of our public service cars. Yeah. Basically, it was designed as a DARE car for our DARE program, mainly to reach the children. When you bring a car like this out to any event, as you can tell, even at an air show type event, it definitely draws the crowd. It was basically from money from asset forfeiture. So, once again, taking from the bad guys and putting it to some good use. And it's been very successful.
So you want to tell us more about the DARE program. What does that stand for people that never heard about it before?
Well, basically, the DARE program, what that basically is, it's kind of an anti-drug and anti, and that's actually kind of changed now into an anti-gang type program also. Basically, we go out there, try to reach the young folks, show them the problems that drugs can cause and alcohol abuse and those kind of things. And in the gangs now, like I said, that's kind of one of our major issues. So we try to reach the kids at a young age, show them, you know, what could happen, show them what their future would be if they get into that line of work, so to speak.
Yeah, so you did say a lot of people have been, you know, coming over here, checking it out, and a lot of questions been asked, so...
Definitely.
Yeah, so one of the questions I overheard was, how fast is this car go?
That's a good point. Of course, we never go over the speed limit, but if you're on a flat track, this thing, I've heard it go over 130 pretty smooth. But it really does take a flat track. The suspension on this, this is the Prowler. It's a little bouncy, so you want to be on a very flat surface.
Yeah, so you think you're going to race Jeff Gordon?
Good point. We'll have to give him a call.
All right. It was nice meeting you, and have fun at the air show today.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Thanks.
See you later. Now, what are you doing here today at the Travis Air Force Show?
Well, I'm a member of the Commemorative Historical Society. We're a World War II, Korea, and Vietnam reenactment group. Well, Living History Museum. We set up at veterans events, air shows, and just about any other place where we display field equipment, uniforms of the soldiers who fought in those three wars.
Sounds fun. So you always liked acting when you were a kid?
Just about, yeah.
Yeah, just like me. So, you know, when you get dressed up and everything, you actually feel like the person, a soldier?
Well, I've actually spent time in the military. I've got 3 years in the regular Army, 3 in the Army Reserve, and 6 in the National Guard. I put on the uniform, and it gives kind of a feeling. Plus, having the military experience, I sort of know what's going on, and I know what the guys have gone through, sort of what they've gone through, and what the guys now are going through at the immersion call.
So what's your name?
My name's George May.
George May, and you're from Concord, California?
Yeah, that's where I'm living, Concord, California.
Yeah. So you want to tell us what you're wearing and what kind of...
This is Tiger Stripe camouflage, as used by a lot of the special operations units during the Vietnam War, Navy SEALs, Army Rangers, Special Forces, and Marine Recon. Since I was Army, I'm doing Army Special Forces.
Yeah. So you want to tell us about this machine gun?
Okay. Well, this is a representation of a Car 15, which is a shortened version of the M16 rifle, which came in the Vietnam War. Basically, it's shortened. It has a telescoping stock made for easy carry and small, usually carried by NCOs or officers or guys carrying other things like radios or other special equipment.
All right. Well, it was nice meeting you, John.
All right. No problem.
See you later. Good. What's your name?
My name is Scott Viscara.
Scott, nice to meet you. All right, so you're a reenactor as well as John, right?
Absolutely, yes.
And what kind of uniform are you wearing?
This actually is a pre-war uniform. It's 1938. It's Army Air Corps. It predates what you'd normally see. It has a belt. It's a four-pocket tunic. And it's your atypical, you know, Army issue dress uniform.
So how do people get started in reenacting?
There's many ways, actually. You can join an organization such as ours. You can buy a vehicle such as theirs. there's many actual ways. There's military shows that you can go to. They can encourage you to buy or sell. And there's always friends who can encourage you to join. So
what's the purpose of reenacting old wars?
Well, actually, to experience or to relate to the GI in the field. We actually don't do that as much as we do civic things, air shows like this, stack displays, what we have here. We go to swing dances, we go into schools, we go into hospitals, honor vets, we do parades, we provide a color guard as well as rifle details to honor monuments. So we do a lot more than just run around in the field and play. We do more in a more of a civic minded thing to pay back and to let the veterans know who are dying, that we care and we're not going to forget them.
Yeah. So what is the name of the organization?
This organization is the Commemorative Historical Society.
And is it located here on the air base?
It's actually not. It's located all over. We're a mobile type of museum. We're a living history museum. So many of the things you see the members own and we bring out, you know, to share with the public. This display is of a relative of ours who actually was in the 8th Army Air Corps during World War II. His name was John Guy, and he flew a P-51, and he was actually one of the first pilots to shoot down a German jet.
Wow.
He was credited. It's a small display as to many of the items, that his dog tags, pictures, him in his uniform, a write-up. So and this is his uniform. You can see, you know, the different, the cut of the uniform, how it differs from today's uniform, how thin these gentlemen were, you know. And he was a first lieutenant in the 8th Army Air Corps, stationed in out of England, flying into Germany.
Now, if people are at home watching and, you know, they want to become a reenactor, you know, is there contact information?
Yeah,
they can get a hold of you?
They can go to our website, which is the Commemorative Historical Society, and it's chslhm.com. And that stands for Commemorative Historical Society Living History Museum. And they can go there and they can contact us or see where we go and what we do.
All right, it was nice meeting you.
Oh, nice meeting you. Thank you.
All right, we'll see you later. Let's go on inside and talk to Laura, one of the pilots of this aircraft, C-17A. Come on, let's go. How's it going?
Good.
Okay. What's your name?
I'm Sergeant Laura Heggie.
Nice to meet you. I'm Vinny, and you're on the Vinnie Langdon Show. People in Vacaville are watching. And what aircraft type is this?
This is C-17 Globemaster.
And how long have you been flying this?
Wow, I've been on this aircraft since 1998.
Wow. You know, where does this plane fly to?
This aircraft is actually stationed at Edwards Air Force Base. We're a flight test center. So we just, we pretty much do a lot of the flight test. But obviously C-17 is a operational type aircraft. So for us, it's, you know, it's pretty unique for us to have a C-17 at Edwards Air Force Base.
Yeah, so is this going to be stationed here at Travis for a while?
The C-17 is, but this particular aircraft is on loan to Edwards. So, but yeah, the C-17s are coming to Travis. So.
You having fun here at the Travis Air Force Show?
Yeah, yeah.
Have you ever been here before?
Oh, yeah. I've been through here quite a few times. I used to be stationed in Charleston, so we'd stop through here.
Yeah. So you want to tell us about these seats? They're kind of different, huh?
Some of the aircraft have red plastic seats, but these are some of the newer seats that the newer aircraft that's coming off the production line have, but they're a lot more comfortable, obviously, for long flights. On the 141s, you have these red seats so you can lay down on. These are not so good to lay down on, but they're a lot better just for sitting. Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm here with Laura, and, you know, this is an awesome plane.
Thank you.
All right. It was nice meeting you.
You too.
See you later.
Thank you.
All right, how's it going? You're still watching the Vinnie Langdon Show, and we are still here at the Travis Air Force Base. Are you having fun?
I am. I'm having a great time.
All right, good. So, are you a pilot?
I am.
Of this aircraft behind us?
We brought the T-6 in from Texas this weekend.
From Texas? Are you from Texas?
I am not.
No? From Travis?
No, I'm from Iowa, actually, originally, but we're stationed in Texas.
Wow. So you want to tell us more about this aircraft?
Yeah, this is the Air Force's primary trainer. It's taken over from that airplane right there, the T-37, and they're phasing these in, phasing those out. So anybody that comes off the street will fly this first and then move on to something bigger and better after that.
Wow. So this is the Air Force. How long have you been involved?
I got commissioned in 2002, so a little bit more than 3 years now.
Wow. That's great. So how'd you get started?
I went through the Air Force Academy, and the rest took off from there.
Cool. So what do you think of those Thunderbird pilots?
Oh, they're the heat, you know, top of the heap, and it's great to watch them every time. It's always impressive to see them.
All right, so you want to show us around the vehicle?
Sure. Start at the front here. We've got the prop, obviously. It's not a jet, but it's driven by a jet engine, basically, just with a prop attached to the front. Obviously, here, coming back, engine sits behind the door there. That's about it. You can see up on the canopy there, we've got two ejection seats, pressurized cockpit, really comfortable airplane to fly. Up in the top there, you can see the stuff up in the top of the canopy, the white cords. Those are actually kind of an explosive cord that pops the canopy off before we go out if we have to use that.
Wow. All right, now I know it's fun to fly an airplane, right?
It is.
But what's the main purpose of flying?
The main purpose of us in this airplane is just to train new guys, train them, kind of indoctrinate them into the flying world, get them going, teach them the basic skills that they'll need to go on to a more advanced aircraft.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you very much, Matt. It's nice meeting you.
Thanks a lot.
How's it going, Gabe?
Things are going good here, Vinny, at Travis Air Force Base for our show here at Travis. We're glad to be here.
Yeah. So where are you guys out of?
Well, we're stationed out of Las Vegas. And we travel, you know, like 8 months out of the year, starting in March to November, just trying to present and promote the Air Force and try to do it with the Thunderbirds Air Show.
So how many planes do you guys fly at a time as a team?
As a team, we bring 8 during the show, and we fly 6 during the show. And you'll have 4 that stay together and 2 that are always zooming in and out. It's a great show. We encourage everybody to come on out and enjoy the show.
All right, Gabe, it was nice meeting you.
Vinny, it's a pleasure meeting you. Guys, come back on out anytime. See the T-Birds. They're number 1. Blue Angels, number 2. All right.
All right.
You're watching the Vinnie Langdon Show. I love this guy. Awesome.
racing with the wind. And the feeling that I'm under. Yeah, I gotta go make it happen. Take the world in a loving embrace. Buy all of the guns and watching. Exploding for space. Like a true nature's child. We were born, born to be wild. We can fly. And what?